Hi, today we're going to have a very interesting topic on the derivative of inverse trigonometric functions. And we're going to use two formulas here. The first one is the derivative of arcsine u is equal to du over dx over square root of 1 minus u squared. And the other one is the quotient rule, or derivative of the quotient of u over v, where v is the numerator and v is the denominator, no? So that will be equal to v, the denominator, d over dx minus u, dv over dx over v squared, the square of the denominator. And we're going to apply those formulas here for our problem number one, which is y is equal to arcsine x over a plus square root of a squared minus x squared over x. So y prime, the derivative of y, is equal to du over dx. So 1 over a, this is a constant, no? So that will be 1 over a square root, no? Of 1 minus x over a, this one here, our u here, is quantity squared. So this is the derivative of arcsine x over a, plus the derivative of the quotient here, no? Which using the formulas of the quotient, no? Derivative of quotient is x, derivative of the denominator, derivative of the numerator, which is a square root of a squared minus x squared, minus the numerator times the derivative of our denominator here, of x, no? Over the square of the denominator. Now, we're going to simplify this one. As you can see, we're going to get the LCD of this 1 minus x over a quantity squared. The LCD is 1 over a, no? So this one becomes 1 over a squared, no? Because this one is x squared over a squared. LCD is a squared. So the radicand is a squared minus x squared. Since the denominator is a squared, we can get the square root of that, which is 1 over a. So this is the derivative of this first term here. So this one here, application of the quotient rule. So the derivative of, or using the power formula, this is raised to 1/2. So derivative of this one is x times 1/2. So we subtract 1/2 minus 1. So that one becomes negative 1. So this becomes the denominator of this one, no? Of this portion here. Minus, no? We can just copy this one. Square root of a squared minus x squared. The derivative of x is equal to 1. So getting the derivative of this one, of this square here, no? Since we, as we said, we just copy this first term here. X times 1/2 of this one times the derivative of x squared, negative x squared is 2x, over square root of a squared minus x squared. So this becomes the denominator, since the derivative of this one is 1/2, negative 1/2, it becomes the denominator of this term here. So since the derivative of x is 1, so we have this portion here, square root of a squared minus x squared. So we square the, we just copy the denominator of x squared. Simplifying this one here, we cancel out 1 over a, what remains is 1 over square root of a squared minus x squared. So for this thing here, so 1/2 times negative 2 times negative 2x is equal to, you cancel out 2 here, negative x, so this one becomes x squared, x times negative x is x squared, no? So getting the LCD of this one 2 here, the LCD is square root of a squared minus x squared. So this one becomes, if we combine this portion here, this polynomial here, so this one becomes square root of a squared minus x squared times this square root of a squared minus x squared. So this becomes a whole exponent of 1, no? So we combine using this common denominator, a squared minus square root of a squared minus a squared. So this becomes our denominator. So this one becomes x squared minus, no? This becomes exponent of 1 minus a squared minus x squared. Okay, and all over the denominator, which is square root of a squared minus x squared. So times, no, times x squared. So this one becomes this negative x squared minus a squared minus minus becomes positive. So x squared cancels out, and this x squared here is combined with square root of a squared minus x squared. So as we continue, we just copy this one minus, no, as you can see, we just disregard, we omit this, get rid of this parenthesis here. So negative x squared, as we have said, plus x squared, so x squared cancels out, and we combine this one, and then since you cancel out, this one becomes 1, no? This one is, we just copy this one, and then what remains here is a negative a squared over x squared times the quantity a squared minus x squared. And then we want to combine also these two terms here. The LCD is x squared times square root of the square root of a squared minus x squared. So we have this x squared here. So you multiply this one by x squared. So what remains here? The result is 1 times x squared is x squared minus, as we combine, minus a squared, and we use the same denominator of x squared times the quantity square root of a squared minus x squared. So after this, we want to rationalize the denominator by multiplying both the numerator and denominator by this radical here, square root of a squared minus x squared times square root of a squared minus x squared. So this becomes an exponent of 1, no? So upon multiplying, we get this portion here, no? X squared minus a squared, no? This quantity here, times square root of a squared minus x squared. So this one becomes an exponent of 1, x squared, with times a squared minus x squared, exponent of 1, no? So radical this square root times square root is to the power of 1. So we want to reverse this, no? X squared minus a squared, by multiplying this polynomial here by negative 1 over negative 1. So this one becomes a squared minus a squared, x squared, times the quantity square root of a squared minus x squared. Just copy the denominator of x squared times the quantity a squared minus x squared. So this one, no, excuse me, something is wrong. So this one, we have this negative here, no? We multiply this, this one becomes negative. So this one is a squared minus x squared times the quantity square root of x squared, a squared minus x squared, times negative x squared, no, this one, times quantity a squared minus x squared. So we cancel out a squared minus x squared by this portion here. So that one cancels out, this one cancels out, no? and also this one cancels out. So what remains is negative square root of a squared minus x squared over x squared. So that's it, no? This is our final answer. And thank you for watching this video. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Bible Friend Dan. And also click that notification bell. No? So thank you again and see you again later.